We now discuss UML's behavioral diagrams, those diagrams that have to do with the behavior, the dynamic aspects of the system, rather than the static ones. The first behavioral diagram I want to discuss is a very fundamental one, the use case diagram. So let's start by seeing what a use case is. A use case represents two main things. First, the sequence of interactions of outside entities, which is what we normally call actors, with the system that we're modeling. And the second thing is the system actions that yield an observable result of values to the actors. And basically, these two things are nothing else than the outside view of the system. So the view of the system in which we look at the interaction between the system and the outside world. If you want a parallel, think about designing a house by considering how you will use the house. And you might have seen use cases called with different names. So for example, they're also called scenarios, scripts, or user stories. But in the context of UML, we will call them use cases. Now let's look at the basic notation for a use case, which is fairly simple. We have a use case, which is represented by an oval with a name, which is the name of the use case. We have an actor, which is represented by this icon and is normally identified by a role name. And finally, we have an edge, which is a solid line that connects actors and use cases and indicates that an actor is the actor of a given use case. And just for completeness, let me note that there are some additional notational elements. But for now, for simplicity, we'll just use these ones.